We are getting some fascinating new details about the American SEAL team that recognized bin Laden in Pakistan and shot him dead. Our next guest said he is certain that some of the special forces in this photo that you see were part of that secretive mission that caught the al-Qaeda leader. Glad to be joined this afternoon by this special guest, Fox News military analyst, Lieutenant Colonel Oliver North. Good to see you, Colonel. What a day. First, just your reaction when
Great
you heard
day.
This news.
Great news, Martha. I got the call yesterday when I was on my way back from the National Rifle Association's annual meeting in Pittsburgh. And, of course, that photo you just showed, mine's the only face you can actually see, and there's a reason for that. The Naval Special Warfare Development Group, or what's formerly known as SEAL Team 6, are guys who really don't want their faces up on television or in the newspapers for lots of good reasons. They're the ones that prove what Ronald Reagan said back when I worked at the White House and the National Security Council staff when he captured the terrorists who hijacked the Achille Lauro. You can run, but you can't hide. And if you try to run from these guys, you just die tired. That's certainly what happened to Obama,
or
excuse me, Usama.
You know what? It is so incredible, the courageousness of these, you know, of these Navy SEALs. When you hear this story, and they could have gone another way. You know, the president could have done this with B-2 bombers and JDAMs, and he, according to all the reports we're hearing, realized that that would have meant that we might never have the positive identification on him, and of course that would lead to open questions for, you know, for time to come. Talk to me about the decision, the president's decision, to send in this incredible elite team.
Well, and obviously that's a courageous decision right there. I mean, the president made that decision, obviously, day before yesterday, put forces in place. They've obviously increased embassy security around the world in, those, in anticipation of what we're now seeing. These kinds of units, the special operations groups that we've been out there with, covered for Fox News, these are remarkable young Americans, the best of the best. They're double volunteers. They go on these kinds of raids, conducting them in the middle of the night, the ones that we've been on out there, by helicopter going to insert to the zone, blasting the way into a compound, and getting in and getting out is all dependent on how good the intelligence is and how good the training is in preparation. They've got UAVs up over top of them, and they've got very good ideas of what's on the ground, but ultimately it comes down to the decision points of each individual soldier, sailor, airman, or in this case, Navy SEAL.
You know, we're getting some information. I'm so fascinated by how they pulled this off. You know, explain to us what you know about, you know, there was a low illumination of the moon. They wanted to time everything perfectly so that they could get low enough to land in this compound. You know, how did it go from there, do you think, Colonel?
Well, the operational details are, I just got an email from a very senior U.S. commander saying we're not going to have those operational details out because we're going to have to do this again and again and again. But here's one of the things that we've got that's an enormous advantage. The night vision equipment isn't simply to improve your visibility at night. It's thermal, so they can see hot spots to include human beings, even dogs, on the ground. Number two, the unmanned aerial vehicles, the Predators and Reapers that they have up over top of the battle site, gives you a perfect picture of what might be coming toward you, or, as they say, squirters trying to get out. And every one of these young Americans has practiced this countless times. So a capture-kill mission, like one that we saw that took down Osama bin Laden, means that these operators have done these kinds of things dozens of times. And this is one of the finest of those kinds of operations you could ever expect, primarily because of the precision with which it was all carried out. I know 40 minutes sounds like a lot of time to some folks, but in fact, it's a very brief period of time to conduct an operation of this magnitude.
It's incredible. I mean, I can just imagine how much your heart is pounding in this situation, and I have to wonder if we'll ever hear the story of this young person who looked Osama bin Laden in the eye and pulled that trigger, because everyone is hailing these young Americans who pulled this off, and our credit goes to them. They are just an astonishing group of talented individuals, and it was an amazing mission.
They'd already been in a gunfight as well. You're right.
Yeah.